Friends, here we are going to see how to automate the installation of required Git version using Bash shell script. See here, I'm going to install required Git by downloading tar file. Suppose if I want to install 2.3.5, suppose, then I will download that particular Git version tarball, then I will extract it, then I will configure, compile, and then finally install. You know, if you have any tar file, if you want to install that, you have simply three steps: configure, compile, and then install. So to compile, you should have GCC, right? So whatever the steps you need for your installation of Git, I already taken care inside of my shell script. You know, if you want to install by using a configure, a compile, and then install, you should have a root privileges, or you should be the root user. Right, first let me open my shell script. I already implemented a shell script. See that what I'm doing is I'm running directly automate git installation.sh. See what it's saying. Please run this script from root user. Now let me enter into root. Now I'm running. So before running, just check it. Is there any git or not? Yes, there is a git. Let me remove that git. Actually, now I'm going to remove that git, because whatever the script I implemented, that script purpose is, if you don't have any git on your host, then it will treat as a fresh installation. If you have already some git, then it will show you that this is so and so git version you have. Do you want to upgrade or downgrade your git version? So based on our input, it will proceed. First, as of now, right, we don't have any git on your host. I removed the git. Now I'm going to run our shell script. See the result. So first of all, our shell script will directly connect with your official Git SCM website. From there, it is going to collect all the available Git versions as of now. So as of now, whatever the Git versions are available with your Git, that is from official website, now it is listing all of them. So these are all the possible Git versions as of today. Right now, and if you observe here, after displaying, it is showing that please select Git version to install. So that means actually I don't have any one of the Git version on my host. That's why it is showing this message. Let me select any one of that. I'm going to select, suppose, 2.3.5. Not only that, you can take 2.6.0, whatever it may be, any version. Just select valid version, then enter. Now see that automatically it is going to download, it is going to extract your downloaded tar.gz file. Then it is going to configure it. After that, it is going to compile it. Then after that, automatically it will install as well. So once the setup is done, finally your shell script itself, it will show you that so and so version you installed on your host, or this is the version now on your host, right? Just wait some time so that our shell script will show you that. Just now we selected Git version as 2.6.0, right? Now our shell script will install a required Git version on behalf of us. Just wait some time, and so that you can see the final output, right? It will take some time. You have to wait for some time. Just wait. And guys, this concept completely I implemented by using functions concept. So if you implement any script in terms of functions, then reusability is there, right? For that purpose, I implemented this shell script completely in terms of functions. Anyway, once it is done, we will see whatever the git required git version we have given, that version will be present on your host after completion of this shell script. Yes, almost done. Now this script you can also modify in different ways. Now see that we selected this 2.6.0. Now just now our shell script installed that git version. You can also check manually. That's it. Now if I rerun, see, previously whenever if you ran your script, it was showing that select required git version. But now see, I'm running. First it will go and connect with your official website. From there it is collecting all the available git versions, then it is displaying. And apart from that, it is also showing that this is the version you have on your host. Previously, you don't have anything like this. Now you got it that because just now we installed 2.6.0. Now again I am rerunning our shell script. Now our shell script is displaying so and so version is there on your host. Now do you want to update or downgrade your Git? Let's just say yes or no. I have given default value as no, just remove that. Then now I want to suppose maybe upgrade or downgrade. Just press enter, press yes, type yes, and then press enter. Then as of now 2.6.0 is there, just remove that. Whatever the required version you want, suppose I want 2.5.6 or some 2.6.3, whatever it may be, you can select it. Now I'm going to select suppose this version. Instead of this, you can also select 2.6.3 or any required version other than 2.6.0. Suppose if I take 2.6.0, see what is the output you are getting. Already you have that, why should we install again? That's why simply your shell script is stopping. Now I am rerunning, right? Again your shell script is going to connect with your remote server, I mean Git FCM website. Then it is collecting all your Git versions which are available as of now. Now I want to suppose downgrade or upgrade. Let's say I want to 2.4.8 or 2.5.6, whatever it may be, you can just provide that value. Just remove default value, then provide your value. Now see that it is going to download, extract, configure, compile, and then install, right? So after completion of this shell script, now you will have on your host some 2.5.6 Git version. Whatever the version we given, same version, it will be present on your host once the shell script is done. So simply what we are doing, based on our required version, automatically we are installing that required Git version on your host with the help of your shell script, right? So guys, if you want to get this complete shell script, it is already there in a downloadable format with our Udemy course. I'm going to provide Udemy course link on the below of this video in the description part. So once if you open your Udemy course, right, if you come here, section 20, real-time practice. So under that, so there is a concept lecture called automate the installation of required Git version using bash shell script. There is a resource, so if you click on that, automatically it will show you the shell, complete shell script. You can download it by clicking on that. Yes, it's downloaded, right? Once it is downloaded, just open that shell script and go with step by step so that you can understand how to write the shell script completely for this situation, right? I already explained here. If you want to get, you can get some clue points how to implement this shell script from this video. So in this video I explained already how to understand this shell script, how you can understand that, right? Okay guys, if you want, you just go through the below link which I'm providing on the description part, then you can download the course and you can get the complete shell script. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video. Yeah, one more thing, let me verify it. Yeah, it has been done, right? Now see that previously you was some 2.6.0, now you have some 2.5.6. that's it. Okay guys, bye.